In this video, I'm going to show you how to make this cute little fox. I also have several other videos on my YouTube channel. For example, this little chicken. And this cute bunny. An adorable koala. And this cute cat. And in this one, I'm going to show you how to make this fox. You need several materials. Yarn, of course. This is Catania yarn. This is a cotton yarn. Here you can see the details. You have orange and black and white. Of course, you need the scissors to cut the yarn. You need some pins. Going to need a needle to sew everything together. And these are safety eyes. The size is 8 millimeters. And of course you need some stuffing. Please use some good quality stuffing to get a nice round shape. You can also use other yarn. This one is, for example, made the left one. The purple one is with Catania yarn, the yarn I also used for the fox. But the other cat is made with some bigger, thicker yarn. And it's called Catania grande. And I also use a different crochet hook for the fox and a cat, small cat. I use a 2.5 millimeter hook, and for the bigger cat I use a 4.0 millimeter hook, and you can see it turns out much bigger, but the shape is the same. I'm going to start by making a magic circle. Just wrap the yarn around your finger twice, go in with the crochet hook, grab the yarn and pull it to the two loops around your finger. Now grab the yarn again and pull it to that loop, the loop on your crochet hook. Now you've made a magic ring. I'm going to remove it from my finger and I'm going to single crochet 6 times in this magic circle. This is going to be the first single crochet. I'm going to go into the magic circle. I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it to the magic circle. I have 2 loops around my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it to the both loops. Now I've made 1 single crochet. I'm going to do that 5 more times. Into the circle, grab the yarn. Then grab the yarn again and pull it to both loops on your crochet hook. And I'm going to make the third one. Now the fourth. Five. And 6. Now we can close the magic circle. To do this, we're going to pull the little piece of yarn a little bit to see which circle becomes smaller. And the circle that becomes smaller, we will pull that one to close the other circle completely. So this is the one that became smaller. I'm going to pull it to close the hole. And now I'm going to pull the little piece of yarn again to close the magic circle completely. Now we can start on the second round. Before we do that, we're going to put a little piece of yarn before the beginning. I do this to mark the rounds. And now we're going to increase in every stitch that we just made. So in this first one, we're going to single crochet 2 times in the same stitch. So this is the first time, first single crochet, and now another time in the same stitch. That is called an increase. So in the second stitch, I'm also going to do the same. Two single crochets in the same stitch. In the third, also two single crochets. And in the end, we will have made 12 stitches. 12 single crochets. Now this is the last one, the sixth stitch, also two single crochets in the same stitch. Now we can start with round three. Before we do that, I'm going to move that small piece of yarn, so I know where my round starts. And in the first stitch, I'm going to single crochet one time. And in the second stitch, I'm going to increase, so two single crochets in the same stitch. I'm going to repeat this 5 more times. So in the next stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Again, 1 single crochet in the first stitch. 2 single crochets in the second stitch. One single crochet in the first stitch. 2 single crochets in the second. I have to repeat this 2 more times, and then I'm at the end of the round. And in the end, we will have 18 stitches. In round 4, I'm going to single crochet one time in the first 2 stitches and do an increase in the 3rd stitch. So in this first stitch, I'm going to do 1 single crochet. Also in the second stitch, 1 single crochet. And in the third, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. I have to repeat this 5 more times. So 1 single crochet in the first stitch, 1 single crochet in the second stitch, and 2 single crochets in the 3rd stitch. Repeat this 4 more times until the end of the round. In round 5, we're going to single crochet in the first 3 stitches, and in the 4th, we're going to do the increase. So in this first stitch, do 1 single crochet. In the second stitch, 1 single crochet. In the 3rd stitch, 1 single crochet. And in the 4th, we're going to do the increase. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And we're going to repeat this 5 more times until the end of the round. In round 6, we're going to single crochet in the first 4 stitches And in the fifth stitch, we're going to do the increase. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second stitch, 1 single crochet. In the third stitch, 1 single crochet. Also in the fourth stitch, 1 single crochet. And in the fifth stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. We're going to repeat this 5 more times until the end of the round. The next 2 rounds, rounds 7 and 8, are really easy. We're going to single crochet in every stitch 1 time. So 1 single crochet in every stitch of this round. And also for the next round. So round 7 and 8, only 1 single crochet in each stitch. In round 9, we're going to single crochet in the first 5 stitches and then do an increase in the 6th stitch. Now this is the 2nd, the 3rd stitch, also 1 single crochet. In the 4th, 1 single crochet. In the 5th, 1 single crochet. And in the 6th, we're going to do the increase, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. We're going to repeat this 5 more times until the end of the round. In the next round, we're going to single crochet in every stitch. So it's a real easy round. In every stitch you do 1 single crochet. In the next round, we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first 6 stitches, and in the 7th we're going to do the increase. This is the third stitch, the 4th stitch, 1 single crochet, the 5th stitch, 1 single crochet, in the 6th stitch, 1 single crochet, and then in the 7th we're going to do the increase, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Repeat this 5 more times until the end of this round. In round 12 to 15, we're going to single crochet in every stitch 1 more time. So the next 4 rounds are going to be really easy. Just 1 single crochet in every stitch. Before we continue to the next round, we're going to put in the safety eyes. I'm going to use 8mm safety eyes. I'm going to put them on the front of the body. The back of the body is where you start your wounds. And there has to be 12 stitches between both eyes. So put in one pin first and then count 12 stitches and put in another pin. The safety eyes are quite thick, so we have to make the hole a little bit bigger, and I'm going to use my crochet hook to do that. Now the hole is a bit bigger. Now I can easily put in my safety eye. And also put the backs on the back side. I'm going to do the same for the other eye. Also make the hole a bit bigger and then put in the safety eyes. Now that our safety eyes are put in, now we can start to continue to crochet with round 16. In round 16, we're going to single crochet in the first 6 stitches. In the second, one single crochet. In the third, one single crochet. In the fourth, one single crochet. In the fifth, one single crochet. In the sixth, also one single crochet. But now we're going to decrease. We're going to single crochet in the next 2 stitches together. And we're going to go into the front loop of the stitches, only the front loop. And then grab the yarn and pull it through both loops. I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it through both loops on the hook. I will show you another time. One single crochet in the first stitch. One single crochet in the second, in the third, in the fourth, one single crochet, in the fifth, one single crochet, in the sixth, one single crochet, and we're going to single crochet the next 2 together. That's called a decrease. And we're going only into the front loops. Front loops of stitch 7 and 8. And then grab the yarn, pull it through both loops, and grab the yarn again and pull it through the loops on your crochet hook. We're going to repeat this 5 more times until the end of the round. This is the last decrease of this round. And then we're going to continue to round 17. In round 17, we're going to do one single crochet in the first 5 stitches. So in this first stitch, we're going to do one single crochet. In the second stitch, we're going to do one single crochet. In the third stitch, one single crochet. In the fourth, one single crochet. In the fifth, one single crochet. And now we're going to decrease the next 2 stitches. Repeat this 5 more times until the end of the round. The last decrease of round 17. In round 18, we're going to do one single crochet in the first 4 stitches and then do the decrease. So in this first stitch, we're going to do one single crochet. In the second, also one single crochet. In the third, one single crochet. In the fourth, one single crochet. And now we're going to decrease the next 2 together. Repeat this 5 more times until the end of the round. This is the last stitch of round 18. Now we're going to round 19. In the first 3 stitches, do one single crochet. And then we're going to crochet the 4th and the 5th together. And repeat this 5 more times until the end of the round. This is the last decrease of round 19. In round 20, we're going to single crochet in the first 2 stitches. And we're going to crochet stitch 3 and 4 together. So this is the second single crochet. Now do the decrease. And you have to repeat this 5 more times until the end of the round. Before we continue to crochet our body, we're going to put in some stuffing. Because it's easier now than in the end when the hole is very small. I always lose a lot of stuffing because if you don't use a lot, it will be the shape of the amigurumi won't be as nice. You want it to be very round. So you just put in a lot of stuffing. So you get a really nice shape. You will also notice that after a while that you made your amigurumi, it will become softer. So it's quite important to put a lot of stuffing in now. I'm not gonna put everything in yet. When I'm completely finished with with the body, I can put in a little bit more. If I put in too much, it will be really hard to finish the last rounds. Now we're going to continue. In the first stitch, we're going to do one single crochet, and we're going to crochet the next two stitches together. You have to repeat this 5 more times until the end of the round. So one single crochet in the first stitch and crochet the next two stitches, stitches 2 and 3 together. Now we're going to do our last round, 22. We're going to decrease 6 times. So the first two we're going to decrease together. Oops, I made a little mistake. I'm going to undo that and then do my decrease. Front loops of the first two stitches and crochet them together, and I'm going to repeat this 5 more times. Now the body is finished. I'm going to fasten off. I can also remove my the white piece of yarn. I don't need it anymore. And I'm going to put in just a bit of more stuffing. Of course, the hole is too small to put my finger in. I'm going to use a chopstick to put in more stuffing. Now I'm going to close the hole by sewing in the yarn in all the 6 stitches of the last round. I'm going to sew only to the front loops. Now I can close the hole by pulling the yarn, and now I just have to sew in the yarn inside the body. I do this several times because I don't want my small piece of yarn to come out again. Now I'm going to show you how to make the tail. Start with a magic circle. Now in the magic circle, I'm going to single crochet 4 times. This is my first single crochet. Now do my second single crochet. My third single crochet. Now my fourth single crochet. And now I've made 4 single crochets. And I have to close the hole. Just pull that piece of yarn to make one loop smaller. And then pull that loop to close the other loop. And I pull the small piece of yarn again. And close the hole completely. Now I can start on round 2. In round 2 we're going to do 4 increases. First put a small piece of yarn before you're going to start with round 2. And then we're going to do an increase, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Also in the next stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. You have to do this 4 times in every stitch. So 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Also in the third stitch, 2 single crochets. And in the fourth stitch, 2 single crochets. And then we will end up with 8 stitches. Now before we continue to round 2, you have to move the your help yarn. And then we're going to do 1 single crochet in each of the 8 stitches. So this is an easy round, 1 single crochet in every stitch. In the next round, round 4, we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first stitch and 2 single crochets in the second. And repeat that 4 times. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. In the first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. In the first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. In the first stitch, do one more, the second single crochet in this stitch, and then in the first stitch 1 single crochet, in the second stitch 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Move the red piece of yarn and start with round 5. In the first 2 stitches we're going to do 1 single crochet, and in the third stitch we're going to do an increase. You have to repeat that 4 times until the end of the round. Round 6 is really easy, just one single crochet in every stitch of this round. Now we're going to already put in the orange yarn, because in the next round we're going to use this orange yarn. I'm going to put the orange yarn on the back of my crochet work. And then I'm going to go in with my needle. And then go, you can see that the orange yarn is in the back of the crochet work. So in this I'm going to do that for these last three stitches. And now I'm going to change the white yarn to the orange yarn. First I'm going to go in with my crochet hook. I'm going to pick up my white yarn, and now I'm going to pick up my orange yarn. Gonna pull that through, and now I can continue with my orange yarn in round 7. It's also smart to put in the white yarn behind the crochet work in the next few stitches. You don't want it to come loose. Well, the first three stitches you're going to do one single crochet. And then we're going to do an increase in the fourth stitch. I have to repeat this 3 more times until the end of the round. Round 8 and 9 are really easy, just single crochet one time in each of the stitches. And do that for round 8 and 9. Now we're going to continue with round 10. In round 10 we're going to single crochet in the first 3 stitches, and then we're going to do a decrease. So in this first stitch I'm going to single crochet one time. Also in the second stitch, single crochet one time. And also in the third stitch. And then we're going to crochet the fourth and the fifth stitch together. Just go into the front loops with your crochet hook and pull the yarn through, grab the yarn again and pull it toward loops, and then we're going to single crochet in the first 3 stitches. And then we're going to do the decrease again, crochet the next 2 stitches together. You have to repeat this 2 more times until the end of the round. Round 11 and 12 are really easy, just do one single crochet in every stitch. This is the end of round 12. We're going to go to round 13. In round 13, we're going to single crochet in the first two stitches. And then we're going to do a decrease in the next two. So this is the second single crochet. And now we're going to crochet the next two together. So single crochet in the first two stitches and then do a decrease of the next two stitches until the end of the round. This is the last decrease of round 13. We're going to go to round 14. In round 14 is really easy, just do one single crochet in every stitch. In round 15, we're going to single crochet in the first stitch and then we're going to do a decrease. Crochet the next two stitches together. Repeat this three more times. So one single crochet in the first stitch and then decrease, crochet the next two stitches together. The next three rounds are really easy, just single crochet one time in every stitch of the round. So do this for round 16, 17 and 18. Now you can remove the red piece of yarn. We don't need that anymore. And now we're going to fasten over the slip stitch in the next stitch. So I'm going to go into that stitch. I'm going to grab the yarn and go immediately to my loop on the crochet hook. That's how you make a slip stitch. Now you just have to put in some toy filling in the tail. I'm going to use a chopstick because, well, it's quite a small hole. Now we're going to make the snout. You start with a magic circle. Wrap the yarn around the finger twice. Go in with your crochet hook. Pick up the yarn. Pick up the yarn again and pull it through. And now we're going to make 6 single crochets into this magic circle. This is the first and the second single crochet, the third single crochet, the fourth, five, and 6. Now I have to close the hole by pulling a small piece of yarn. First I'm going to pull the round that's getting closer to close the other one. Now pull the small piece of yarn again. Then the magic circle is closed. Now in the next round I'm going to single crochet 2 times in every stitch. First I'm going to put in a piece of yarn and now I'm going to single crochet 2 times into this stitch. Also in the next stitch, 2 single crochets. And also in the next 4 stitches, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Then in the end, we'll end up with 12 stitches. Also in the last stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. I'm going to move my marker yarn and then do 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. So round 3 is really easy, just 1 single crochet in every stitch. In round 4 we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first stitch and then an increase, 2 single crochets in the same stitch in the second stitch. So in this first stitch 1 single crochet, in the second 2 single crochets in the same stitch. One single crochet. And then 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Now I have to repeat this 4 more times until the end of the round. In round 5, we're going to single crochet 1 time in the first 2 stitches. And then we're going to do an increase in the 3rd stitch. So, the first stitch 1 single crochet. Second stitch 1 single crochet. And in the 3rd stitch 2 single crochets in the same stitch. You have to repeat this until the end of the round. Round 6 is really easy. You're just going to do one single crochet in every stitch of this round. Now we're going to fasten off with a slip stitch in the first stitch of the last round. And then your snout is done. To make the nose, we're going to single crochet 5 times into a magic circle. And because I'm using black yarn, it's a little bit hard to see. But I'm making 5 single crochet into this circle. And when I'm done, I'm going to then the nose is done. It's just one round, and then you do a slip stitch into the first single crochet of the last round, and then your nose is done. Now we're going to make the ear. Start with a magic circle. In this magic circle, we're going to single crochet 4 times. This is the first single crochet. Second. Third. And a 4th single crochet. Now we need to close the hole. And now we can continue to the second round. Just place in a piece of marker yarn first before you start on the second round. And then we're going to increase in every stitch of this round. So 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Also in the last one, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And then we can move our marker and start on round 3. In round 3, you're going to single crochet in the first stitch and then do an increase in the second stitch. And you have to repeat this 4 times in total. Now we're going to make round 4. In round 4, we're going to single crochet in the first 2 stitches and then do an increase. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. In the second stitch, 1 single crochet. In the first stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Repeat this 3 more times until the end of the round. In round 5, we're going to single crochet in the first 3 stitches, and then in the fourth stitch, we're going to do the increase. So now in the second stitch, 1 single crochet. In the third stitch, 1 single crochet. And in the fourth, we're going to do 2 single crochets in the same stitch. You have to repeat this until the end of the round. Round 6 and 7 are really easy. You just have to single crochet 1 time in every stitch of the round. Do this for round 6 and round 7. Now we need to fasten off the slip stitch and you have to make 1 more ear. Now the ear is quite round. I'm going to flatten it to make the shape of the ear. Also remove the marker yarn. So now it has the correct shape. We're going to make the feet. Start with a magic circle. And single crochet 6 times into the magic circle. This is the first single crochet. And the second single crochet. The third single crochet. Fourth. Fifth and the last one, 6 single crochets. Now we need to close the magic circle Now we can start with round two. First put in a piece of marker yarn. Now we're going to increase in every stitch of this round, a 2 single crochet into every stitch, and then you will end up with 12 stitches. Rounds 3 and 4 are really easy. You just have to single crochet in every stitch of the round. Do this for 2 rounds. In round 5, we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first 2 stitches, and then we're going to crochet the 3rd and 4th stitch together. Now 1 single crochet, the next stitch, again 1 single crochet. And then crochet the next 2 together. Then single crochet the next stitch. Also 1 single crochet and the next. And then crochet the next 2 together. Now the small feet is done, you can remove your marker yarn and you just have to finish it with a slip stitch. You need to flatten the feet to get the correct shape. And make another feet. The inside of the ear. To make the inside, we have to start with making a chain. First, I'm going to make a little loop. And now I'm going to chain 6 times. And this is the first. Second, third, four, five, and 6. Now we have to, we're going to single crochet into the chain. You have to skip the first chain and then we're going to single crochet 5 times. This is the first time, second, and the third, the fourth, and the fifth. Now I'm going to make one chain and then I'm going to turn my crochet work. I'm going to skip the first stitch again. The first stitch I'm going to skip and then I'm going to single crochet 4 times. By skipping the first stitch, my crochet work will become smaller and will get the shape of the ear. So after 4 times, this is the 4th time, I have to make a chain again. And I'm going to turn the crochet work. And then skip the first stitch and then do 3 single crochets. Make one chain, turn the crochet work and skip the first stitch and then make 2 single crochets. Now I'm going to make a chain, turn your crochet work and go into the second stitch and make 1 single crochet. Now you can fasten off your crochet work. Now we made the ear. You have to make 1 more. Now you need to sew the inside of the ear onto the ear. I'm going to show you every step of how to sew the inside of the ear on the ear, because I know it can be quite difficult to get this really neat. When I go into my ear with my needle, I go just a little bit further. And then I'm going to go into the white part from the back side to the front side. And then I'm going to sew into the ear again. And I'm always going into the same hole that my thread just came out of. So here I'm going to sew into the inside here, and I'm going to go into the same hole again, and then sew further. Yeah, I'm almost done with the sewing on the inner part of the ear. Now I just have to hide the yarn inside the ear. I forgot to do this on a video, but it's also smart to make a little knot in those two white pieces of yarn. So that you're sure that the white part stays on the ear. Now we're going to sew the snout on the head. To do this, first I'm going to go with my needle into the first stitch of the last round. So the shape looks then a bit nicer. And then I'm going to pin the snout between the eyes on the head. And I'm going to pin them between rounds 9 and 18. So round 9 is just above the snout. And round 18 is just below the below the snout. Now that I have pinned on my snout correctly, I can start sewing. I'm going to start sewing into the head. Now from the head I'm going to go to the inside of the snout to the outside. And then go into the same hole that the yarn just came out of, so out of the head, so the orange. The same hole in the orange part. And then I sew further. I will show you again every step, so you can make sure you have it sewed on the same way. Maybe for some people this video will take a long time, but I also heard from beginners and lots of people that make amigurumi, that it's really nice to see every step of sewing on the all the parts, because it's probably the most difficult part of making an amigurumi. When you just have a little small hole left, it's time to put in stuffing into the snout. Use a lot of stuffing in the snout to get a firm shape. Here I'm using the back side of my crochet hook to get the stuffing in. And once this is done, you can continue to sew on your snout onto the head. Now, snout is sewed on. Now I just have to hide my yarn inside the snout and then cut it off. Now it's time to sew on the nose. I'm going to sew on the nose on round one of the snout. This is a little bit harder to see because the nose is black. It's going to be sewed on the same way as I did the snout on the head. When you have sewed on the nose, then you just have to hide the yarn inside the snout. Now we just have to cut off the yarn, and then the nose is done. Now we're going to sew on the ears, on the head, on the body, body and head. And it's going to be sewed on between rounds 5 and 13. I'm just going to put in some pins to count my rounds. And then it's easy to know where I have to pin on the ear. And the bottom side of the ear is going to be about 7 stitches from the eye. I'm going to put a pin there. And then I'm going to put on the ears, pin on the ears. I'm also going to pin on the other ear before I start sewing. Also between round 5 and 13, the bottom 7 stitches from the eye. Because before I start sewing, I want to know for sure that everything looks nice. So the ears look correctly together on the head. Now I'm going to sew on the ears on the head. I'm going to start on the bottom side, because this is where my yarn is. First I'm going to sew to the ear, and then I'm going to sew to the head. I'm going to sew to both layers of the ear. The ear is folded and has 2 layers on the bottom. And that I'm going to sew to both of them. Again, I will show you every step. Now that I'm finished with chewing on the ear, now I just have to hide the yarn. First I'm going to sew in the top of the ear a few times. I want the ear to be sewed on very sturdy, especially if you make a toy for kids, you don't want the ear to come loose. So make sure you sew it in a few times. And then sew into the head and a few times and then cut off the yarn. Now I can start on sewing the other ear. You can see that the yarn is in the middle. And I should have thought about that and probably to make sure that it was on the bottom or the top, but I accidentally have it in the middle now. So I'm going to go sew to the bottom and then sew from the bottom to the top. Now I'm the top at the end, just have to sew it in a few times. And then I can hide the yarn in the body. Now we can cut off the yarn and then we can continue to sew on the feet. These are the small feet. I'm going to sew into the last stitch of the first stitch of the last round. And then I'm going to sew them on the bottom of the body. First pin on both of the feet. And then you check on the front to see if you have placed them correctly. I'm just checking to see if I like the shape. Well, if it looks good, you can start sewing on. Also for the feet, you have to sew to both layers of the feet. First we're going to sew on the last round that we made from the feet. I always keep checking to see if the feet are placed correctly. They might move a bit while sewing. Once you have sewed on the bottom side, Then you have to also sew on the middle of the feet onto the body. So if I remove this pin now, these pins, then you will see it's quite loose. So what I need to do is go and sew on the top side of the ear, of the feet, sorry, and sew that onto the body. And you will also notice that the shape of the feet will become rounder. Well, if you like the shape of the feet, you just have to hide the yarn in the body and cut off the yarn. And we can start with the second feet. I'm going to sew on the second feet now. Again, first sew on the last round of the feet onto the body. You are done with sewing on the last round, then we're going to remove the pins and sew on the middle part of the feet onto the body. Once you have sewed on the middle part of the feet onto the body, you just need to hide the yarn inside the body and then cut the yarn off, and then we can start sewing on the tail. So we're almost done. The tail is going to be sewed on the back of the body in the middle between rounds 14 and 18. So the top of the tail below round 14 and the bottom of the tail above round 18. First start sewing into that first stitch of the last round. And then we can sew it onto the body. Of course, it's much easier if you pin it first. Start by sewing into the body and then go into the tail. Again, I will show you every step. Now I'm just checking if the tail looks correctly. And then I just have to hide my yarn in the body. Now your fox is done. I hope you enjoyed making him. I have several more videos in my YouTube channel. If you like, you can also buy written patterns from my Etsy shop. The link is in the description of this video. I have this cute koala and this cute donkey available. Thank you very much for watching my video. Please like and subscribe to my channel if you enjoyed making him.